Health Affairs for Parkland. I report directly to Dr. Lawyer. Okay, no problem. Are we up to speed?
Yes.
All right, I report directly to Dr. Lawyer, and I am here to listen to what you have to say. And I can tell you right now that I don't have enough information on this situation to comment. But as an information taker, it's my responsibility to follow up as soon as possible and make sure we get information back to you. I mean, I didn't know this was coming, and I was sitting in my office, and I appreciate your coming by to talk to us about your issues and your concerns, and I do want to listen, and feel free to say what you need to say, and know that I will be briefing Dr. Royer on it, and I'm sure the board is going to be interested in what you're saying also. What would be helpful to me, again, my name is Jennifer Cotrere, and what would be helpful...
Please go ahead.
Okay, tell me when to slow down. If you would go around the room and give me some idea of who you are and who you represent. And Candace, would you help just so I know? And then if there is a spokesperson for the group, or is there somebody who you elected to represent you, or who just want to talk as a group, that's fine. I'm willing to listen either way.
We'd like to talk as a group, but the most important voices in the room are...
Could you pull up a chair? Okay, Jorge? Omar. And Omar? Omar.
I'm good with the translator.
Secretary of the translator.
Okay. And please, when you speak directly then, from the staff side, to go direct to the person you're speaking with.
Okay, okay. Well, why don't we start with the spokespersons? And we're going to ask you to translate, so Candace gets down everything. I'm going to be taking notes, and so will Candace. Candace works in corporate communications also. And like I said, we want to be able to make sure that we get accurate information. Okay, who would like to start? Okay, and once again, you're Omar.
No, I'm Esther Omar, ¿verdad?
Okay, and is there a particular group you represent?
Hay un grupo en particular en cual tú representas. The Diamba. The Diamba Steel.
Okay, spell that for me, please.
¿Cuál es la letra? Can you spell? ¿Cuál es la letra, por favor? Escríbelo, puedes escribirlo. I'm getting the spelling correct.
That's fair. I mean, please. I just want it to be accurate for us to get good information. Would you like me to call him Mr. Last name or
Omar?
Okay, I'm Jennifer, so
Soy Jennifer, estamos bien.
Please.
Por favor, comienza.
Estamos aquí porque
we are here because we have problems with the water, with the medics, all that, the opportunities that one has to get medical insurance, the breaks, the things for work, they don't give us anything.
Safety equipment.
We would like for us to be respected. And we were fine then. We were fine. I
más que le gustaría decir? Is there something else you would like to say? Well, they don't give us the breaks. They just give us lunch break. So like he said, like as soon as the break is almost over, we have to go upstairs and start working. That's it. Jorge.
Okay, mi nombre es Jorge.
Okay, my name is Jorge.
También trabajo para Diambra.
I also work for Diambra. Well, the reason why we've come here for, we know that Diambra is working here in Parkland.
Lo que queremos
and
es que
what we want is that
la compañía general,
the general contractor
que le provee trabajo a Diambra,
that provides work to Diambra
sepa
knows
en las condiciones que nos tiene trabajando.
The working conditions that we're working on.
Porque a lo mejor
because maybe
la compañía general,
the general contractor
no sabe,
doesn't know
cómo tiene trabajando la gente, en qué condiciones la tiene trabajando.
The delivery condition of the people.
Trabajamos tarde.
We work late.
Yo personalmente
I personally have worked until 11 o'clock p.m.
7 a 11 de la, 7 de la mañana.
From 7 a.m. to 11 p.m.
Con solamente 30 minutos.
With only one 30-minute break.
No tiene aseguranza.
We don't have health insurance.
No provee agua.
We are not provided with water.
Ni el equipo de seguridad.
No, nor the safety equipment.
Queremos que esto se sepa.
That this be known.
Hay mucha gente trabajando.
There's a lot of people working in Diambra.
En las mismas condiciones.
In the same conditions.
Queremos que las compañías generales
and we want the general contractors, general companies to know.
Que lo piensen antes de
we
darle un trabajo a Diambra.
We want them to think about that before getting a work to Diambra.
En toda la gente que tienen
en and all the people that they have in these unsafe laboring conditions.
Es lo que tengo.
That's what I have. This person here at the back is saying, George, respect and dignity at work is also what we want.
Uno tiene miedo también
one is afraid of,
decirles,
of saying, telling them, I'm going to the bathroom.
Porque dicen
because
que tardo mucho.
They say we take a lot of time, or it takes a lot of time.
Uno a veces aguanta
so we have to hold it sometimes.
Por miedo a perder el trabajo.
Or afraid that we will lose a job.
Igualmente, el agua es lo mismo.
The water is the same.
El equipo de herramientas si no lo traes.
The equipment if you don't bring it.
Que te vete para la casa.
And then go home.
Pardon me, what about the equipment?
Okay, ¿qué es lo que dijo acerca del equipo de trabajo?
Si no traes guantes,
if you don't have gloves, if you don't bring gloves,
o lentes de seguridad,
or gloves for security, safety gloves,
no puedes trabajar.
You cannot work.
No te los dan.
They don't provide us to us. What he's saying, they need to bring them the equipment.
Uno tiene que comprar.
One's got to buy them.
Actually, I don't.
I'm translating. That's what I'm doing.
Oh, he's asking if I have any questions.
Yes, that's what he does. Well, I think we have any questions. I think that's what he wanted to say.
I don't have any questions.
No tengo ninguna pregunta.
At this point in time.
Hasta el momento hasta que.
Because I am not here to negotiate these issues.
Yo no estoy aquí para negociar estos problemas.
I'm issued to, I'm here to record the issues.
Para saber cuáles los problemas son.
And to talk to those who are in charge here about it.
En cargos que están a cargo.
And to come up with a response.
Y dar una respuesta a estos problemas.
Like I said, a meeting has not been scheduled and.
No se ha formado un tiempo con el cual se va a hacer el meeting.
And the reason why is because we did not know, or at least in my role, I did not know these issues existed. And what your concerns about these issues, I didn't know anything about this. And we have to first find out what's going on, obviously, and go forward with these issues. I would like to get as much information as possible. If there is more information you'd like to share with me, I want to hear it.
Yo quiero escucharla.
We have as much time.
Tenemos demasiado tiempo.
As you need.
Como ustedes necesiten.
And if anyone else wants to talk.
Alguien más quiere hablar.
Or ask questions or have concerns.
O tiene problemas o.
This is the time.
Este es el momento.
To voice them.
Para decir, darlas a conocer.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, my name's Adrian. I work for a company named Great Western Directors. We also in a strike against this company for the same reason those guys got.
Can we slow down? You work for?
Great Western Directors. Also, we in a strike against this company for the same reason the guys from Yamba had. We went to the job site 2 days ago to get them out to support them when they're going to strike against this company, Yamba. And we actually seen there was a lot of workers, probably there were like 15 workers there, and there was no water at all. And now, we went yesterday again, and they have 5 buckets of water now. They're trying to cover everything they've done, but we know that this company, they treat this worker pretty bad. So that's why we're trying to pass the information to you guys, so that you know that they, Parkland Hospital will interview, but those are all this with justice. And probably you don't know about it, what we hear. And that's very important to pay attention to the workers, because you're the one that pays this company to be treated well.
I'm still writing, so if you please forgive me for being a little slow.
I'd like to say something just really quickly. I can't wait to leave. I'm a student at the University of North Texas, and I heard about what was going on with workers that Parkland Hospital was contracting out to. And I just know that, you know, a place where people come to receive medical attention, the people that they're contracting out to that are building the hospital should have access to the hospital that they are building. And I think that, you know, this is something that you need to, that, you know, whoever the decision makers in the hospital are should take into consideration. So the people that are putting their labor into building this hospital don't have access to the hospital. They don't have health insurance. They can't take their family there when they're sick. And they're being paid $14 an hour to labor from 8 o'clock in the morning until 10 o'clock, 10 or 11 o'clock at night with no bathroom breaks. You know, and I think that Parkland Hospital needs to take very seriously how workers on the job are being treated and make sure that they are being treated fairly. And that includes, you know, better pay. $14 an hour for the kind of labor that they're doing is also not enough.
I'm Gene Lance from the Texas Alliance for Retired Americans. I'm the president. We talked with the young men earlier, and everyone asked them about different kinds of benefits like unemployment compensation, workers' comp, pensions were not even mentioned. But what really impressed me is that these working people that are doing this very difficult job didn't even know what those things were. They did not have any of the benefits accorded to American workers. They don't even know that, that those benefits even exist.
L-A-N-T-Z.
And you're with the Texas Alliance?
I'm the president of the Texas Alliance for Retired Americans.
Thank you, Ms. Jones. Yes, ma'am.
Hi, my name is Cassandra Gueran.
No, Ms. Cassandra.
Would you spell your last name?
G-U-E-R-R-A. My question for you, you may or may not know the answer is this a publicly funded job site? The project, does it have any form of public funding?
Yes, it does. And Walter, if you would like to address that, we are, as you well know, a governmental entity and public money is being used to build this hospital.
So are you guys aware that, I mean, you guys weren't aware of the situation, but in the state of Dallas, there's an ordinance that says that construction workers are only allowed to operate between 7 and 7 p.m. Monday through Friday, and 7 and 8 and 1 p.m. Saturdays.
Okay, between 7 a.m.?
7 a.m. and 8, 7 p.m. Monday through Friday. And 8 to 4 on Saturdays. As the city of Dallas ordered. I apologize, I don't have the ordinance number. It's also federal law that workers get 15-minute breaks for 4 hours. Somebody correct me if I misquote it. But if you're working 8 hours, then you're entitled to at least a 30-minute lunch and 2 15-minute breaks. Aside from not being able to take bathroom breaks, when they are allowed, they have to walk at least 10 minutes to get to the bathroom. And another 10 minutes to come back. That's not even including the time to relieve themselves. That's all I have to say. I just wanted to make sure you guys were aware.
I think it's very important right now that we be in a listening mode from Parkland and that we hear everything that's important to you so that we have a chance to assess what's going on. And to start, we have to listen very clearly to this carefully. And that's why I want you to know that my role here is to listen. And if there's anyone, I realize that you know, there may be other people who have something to say and are thinking about it, and maybe even shy, but that's okay. I'm here, and I will stay until you're finished. I will see that our leadership gets these concerns or any questions that you might have, and that will get back to you in an appropriate amount of time to discuss this. thank you for identifying your leaders. We will contact the leaders directly. I have to admit, I may not have my card with me because I ran out of the office pretty quickly. And I did not grab my other bag that I used to bag, have with me. But if you have a pen, my name is Jennifer.
My number is Jennifer.
J-E-N-N-I-F-E-R. And the last name is C-U-T-R-E-R. And as I stated, my badge says Vice President of Legislative Affairs, Public Affairs now. I just haven't had my badge changed. And I work directly, as I said, for Dr. Royer, who reports directly to the board. Now, this is what I intend on doing. I'm going to take your list of concerns, and I'm going to type them up, and I'm going to schedule a meeting with Dr. Royer as soon as possible. And as you're aware, I'm not sure how available he is because we're getting ready to go into a long weekend. And you need to give us until next week, but I will schedule as soon as possible. What I would like to have is the full name and address, well, phone numbers, you know, where we can reach Jorge and Omar. Are you spokesman? That's pretty much. It seems to be, and we will call them directly, and we will have somebody who can translate. If we need to have, we have people, obviously, who speak Spanish. Many people speak Spanish in Parkland.
So you're saying you need to have their name and...
Name and contact phone number.
Contact information.
Yeah, contact...
Mine, please have my little note.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Okay.
And, you know, if you want to write it in my book to make sure it stays or whatever. Okay. Anyone else who wants to give me their name and phone number, I might be hearing from you, or...
Actually, ma'am, I would like you people with badges, for the sake of my YouTube page, to give me your name so that I get your name correct on my YouTube page.
Sure. It's Jennifer Contreras, Vice President of Public Affairs.
Candace White.
Your title, ma'am?
Media Supervisor.
Thank you. Jean, you're ruining my shot. Yes, your name, ma'am?
Kathy Harper.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm the director of clinical planning.
Okay. Jean, you're ruining my shot.
Where do I go?
Yes, your name, sir?
Walter Jones, Senior Vice President of Facilities.
Thank you. I'm about to run out of battery. I wanted to get there.
Issues, you know, will you be here outside of the building, or you just want to get some idea of what your plan is, would like to share that with us, because we're concerned about people, obviously, safety and crowds and whatever, and whatever you plan on doing is, you can all know this is public access out here. So I'm just going, I'm concerned about your safety, protection, and any kind of crowd issues you may need to address. Is there anything that I need to know?
Oh, I have a question, Mr. Miller.
Sure.
I don't know, at Parkland Hospital, they have a safety guy on the job side, or somebody can check on the jobs? Are you trying to find out, and another thing, trying to find out, we hear that, or Ron, the last person, CEO for the Parkland, I think they possibly put in prevailing wages on the job side. We're trying to find out if they, some kind of way to get those prevailing wages, so we can talk to the workers, but, because I don't think the, some of the workers, they can pay what they're supposed to be getting paid in the jobs. So we're trying to see if, some kind of way we can get those prevailing wages, how much is going to be in the job. And we can talk to those guys, let them know that they don't get the pay, the pay they're supposed to get paid.
And actually, on public sites, publicly funded sites, that information should be posted.
Yeah, and possibly, I think they possibly have them in the trailer or somewhere in the job site too. So, but I don't think those guys, the workers, they know about it, so, and, I mean, I don't think they, owners of the company, they're going to tell them anyway. They just pay whatever they want.
Actually, I don't have anything to add, but I would like to say there are a couple different unions that are represented here, and...
A couple of different unions?
Yes, there are a couple different unions here, and I wanted to say on behalf of the Texas State Employees Union, that we're certainly in solidarity with the guys.
Is that what now, Texas State Employees?
The Texas State Employees Union.
Do you have a statement or anything else you want to make, other than acknowledging it here?
We're just in solidarity with these guys as well.
Okay, thank you. I appreciate your clarification.
They expressed themselves very well. I don't have anything to add to that.
Would you like to give me your name, please?
It's fine. My name's Clinton.
Clinton?
Yes, ma'am.
And your last name?
McBride, McBride.
Okay, since I didn't give out cards, if any of you want to take down that number, that means you can call me, okay? And I'm sorry, I just ran over here because I knew y'all were standing outside of this meeting. I need to talk to you, I want to make sure you were acknowledged immediately.
Is it possible that we'd be able to meet with a board representative?
Is that the recommendation of the group, spokesman, or if y'all, I mean, if that's something you want?
Es algo que quieren, ustedes quieren tener una reunión con una persona.
I mean, I certainly can put in a request.
Es solamente, es lo que está diciendo, puede poner una a requisitar, con escribir una petición para que ustedes puedan tener un meeting en board. Of course, yes.
And also, whoever it is that cuts the check to the company, that person should definitely be there as well.
Esa es una persona que le da el dinero a la compañía, y también debe estar ahí.
Or would that be you, sir? No.
Omar is telling me that the general contractor should be there.
sir, as a translator, do I need to get your name in case?
No, you don't need to get my name.